हेलो, मैसेल्फ डॉक्टर मनीषा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ फैकल्टी फिजियोथेरेपी डिपार्टमेंट इन RPIT टेक्निकल एंड मेडिकल कैंपस करना। वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल इन RPIT एकेडमिक्स। इफ यू लाइक द कंटेंट ऑफ दिस चैनल, प्लीज लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब। टूडेज माई टॉपिक इज अस्थमा। वॉट इज अस्थमा? अस्थमा इज अ क्रॉनिक इन्फ्लामेटरी डिसऑर्डर ऑफ द एयरवेज। Causes recurrent episodes of coughing, wheezing, breathlessness and chest tightness. These episodes are usually associated with widespread but variable airflow obstructions that is often reversible either spontaneously or with treatment. Signs and symptoms: wheezing due to airstream turbulence and vibration of mucus, rapid breathing and shortness of breath, dyspnea, coughing, chest tightness, hyperinflation of thorax, voluntary at first to dilate airway secondarily as a result of incomplete emptying, markedly reduced FEV1, forced expiratory volume, attacks rapidly last from a few minutes to several hours, are often associated with exercise or sleep. Etiology of asthma. Two types of asthma have been described: extrinsic or allergic asthma, intrinsic or idiopathic asthma. Extrinsic or allergic asthma, mediated by IgE, usually begins in childhood, less common in adults, usually associated with atopy, sensitization to allergens is key feature. Increased indoor play and exposure to indoor allergens decrease childhood infections, inhibit normal development of immune system, leading to increases in allergic responses. Intrinsic or idiopathic asthma, more common in adults, usually not associated with atopy. Patients may have nasal polyps, aspirin sensitivity, sinusitis, attacks may be precipitated by infection, exercises, inhaling cold air, emotional factors. Exercise induced is most common form of intrinsic. Asthma triggers kya hote hain jinki wajah se asthma hone ke chances zyada hote hain? Can be physical, chemical, environmental or pharmacologic in nature. Common triggers: mold, pollen, house dust, mites, pet dander, cockroach antigens, cigarette smoke, perfume and other chemicals, example cleaners, viral infections, cold air exercises, aspirin. Pathophysiology: well recognized as an inflammatory condition, chronic airways inflammation results in increased smooth muscle cell proliferation and hypertrophy, leading to thickening of the airway wall, increased mucus production, airway edema, and result is partial airway obstruction and difficulty in airflow movement. This is the diagram. There is normal bronchial tube, airway passes, normal muscles, wall, normal lining, and the side one is asthmatic bronchial tube, swollen lining, thick spasmed muscle wall. हम डायग्राम के अंदर देख सकते हैं कि हमारे नॉर्मल एयर पासेज कौन से हैं और asthmatic bronchial tube हमारी कैसी है, वहाँ पे हमारी जो लाइनिंग है वो swollen हो जाएंगी, thick spasmed muscles wall दिखाई देंगी हमें। ठीक है, थैंक यू।